Supreme, which is known for its iconic Y on Red box logo, was started by James Jebbia. The brand evolved from a small skate store in downtown Manhattan to becoming a phenomenon in the fashion industry, and with every new product release, they cause a pandemonium. Their high status as a streetwear brand has earned them the opportunity to collaborate with some of the biggest names in the fashion industry, such as Louis Vuitton, Lacoste, the Jordan Brand, and many others. In 1994, Supreme was founded by James Jebbia, and its doors first opened on Lafayette Street in downtown Manhattan. James Jebbia had skaters in mind when he was designing the store. The store is arranged in a way which had the clothes not only in the middle of the store, but on the sides, which left room in the center of the store for the skaters to ride around and feel comfortable. For the next 10 years after 1994, Supreme only had a single store. But it all changed in 2004 when James Jebbia decided to open up a second store in Los Angeles. The new store was much better than the one in New York. It was 2 times bigger and it even included an indoor skating pool. As time went on, James Jebbia opened other Supreme stores all over the world, including stores in France, England, and Japan. In total, there are 11 Supreme stores worldwide, and they still have the same theme to them, which is a skater-friendly design, as the first Supreme store. It would make sense to say that Supreme's success can be attributed to its logo. Because after all, what is a brand without its logo? When the first Supreme store opened in Manhattan, James Jebbia's goal was to sell popular skating brands within the skating community. James Jebbia wanted to celebrate the store's grand opening by selling 3 original t-shirts. The 3 t-shirts were all simple in their designs, one featuring Travis Bickle from the movie Taxi Driver, and the last t-shirt, which featured the simple Supreme logo. The simple t-shirt ended up becoming the highest selling product in the store. James Jebbia realized that he might have found something special with the logo, so he applied the logo on a wide range of clothing products in a variety of colors. Not too long after, the Supreme logo gained popularity in the street culture of New York City, and it became a status symbol, which eventually would pave the way for it to become internationally popular not only in skating culture but also in hip-hop culture as well. With popularity, controversy often follows. After James Jebbia's friend designed him the original Supreme logo, James Jebbia felt as if the logo can be improved upon, so he gave his friend a book by a conceptual artist named Barbara Kruger for inspiration. In the end, the new logo looked a lot similar to Barbara Kruger's work. Her work featured bold white letters surrounded by red font in order to portray a rebellious message. Some of her famous works include Her Body is a Battleground, which was a poster for the support of legal abortion during the 1989 Women's March on Washington. Unfortunately, Barbara Kruger could not take any legal action against Supreme because she did not own any copyrights on the logo itself. In the end, the Supreme logo became very lucrative for the brand because of Kruger's work, which conveyed the message of rebellion, and it perfectly fit the demographic that Supreme was trying to reach. Now you may ask, what is it about Supreme that makes it popular? And the answer to this question relies on several factors. The first one being is variety. Supreme produces a wide variety of products. They make t-shirts, jackets, shoes, backpacks, crowbars, bolt cutters, and even bricks. The brand markets towards young people, and because of the versatility of their products, they are seen everywhere, which further increases their popularity. The second factor is celebrity popularity. Many celebrities have been seen wearing Supreme products such as Tyler the Creator, Justin Bieber, Kanye West, Kid Cudi, and many more. The Supreme brand being embraced within the celebrity culture has given it a huge boost in popularity. The last factor is scarcity. Every time Supreme releases a new product, it is always in a limited quantity. Since there is a huge demand for the product and there is a limited supply, consumers are always excited whenever there is a new release because of how rare Supreme seems to be. Because of these factors, Supreme items sell out quickly and people have to buy them in secondary markets, which is even more expensive. For example,
because Supreme drops sell out immediately, people have to buy it on secondary markets, and Supreme items become even more expensive on the resale market. Resellers call this the Supremium. The Supreme North Face jacket, retail, $300, flipped for more than $1,600. That's a return of 463%. And the Supremium applies to truly random shit. Supreme sells a branded crowbar, retail, $32, resale, 360. Supreme bolt cutters, retail 48, resale 222. And if you're not mad yet, parents, this is a Supreme brick. Retail 30, resale $150.
And this too also applies to other items that have the Supreme logo on it. Supreme has come a long way. It was able to go from being a small skate shop on Lafayette Street in Manhattan to becoming a globally popular brand with 11 stores worldwide. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give this video a big thumbs up and also subscribe for future content. And also follow me on my Instagram. All right, see you next time.